Several years ago, the story of a young man named Vlad got covered by all the Russian and even foreign media. It made perfect sense because people all over the world were amazed at how a very young schoolchild managed the village household all on his own. He didn't just manage to keep the house like an adult man, but also, most importantly, to take care of his partial paralyzed mother. However, the part that seemed the most incredible and upsetting was that the boy had to become the head of the family when he was 8 years old. That was the moment when his whole life changed drastically. The tragedy of the Kuzrashov family developed according to a scenario that is painfully familiar to many people living in godforsaken villages far from civilization. A few years after Vlad was born, his father developed an addiction to alcohol and began to pay less and less attention to his wife and child. The boy's mother, Tatiana, was a strong and independent woman who tried to help her husband kick the habit and get him to come back to the real life, so to say. However, after realizing that nothing was going to change, she refused to tolerate his drinking, as thousands of other women do, and left the man. That's how Tatiana ended up in a dilapidated wooden house in the middle of nowhere with a small child on her hands. She simply had nowhere else to go. Of course, the life of their small family could not be called good or easy, but the most important thing was that they were together, and that was enough for the woman. Tatiana worked tirelessly, and little Vlad helped her the best he could. Thus, they weren't really in need of anything. They were happy with what they had. However, when Vlad was 8 years old, trouble knocked at their door. One day, the woman felt a sharp pain, and as it turned out later, her body couldn't withstand everything she had to go through. Vlad's mother had a stroke, after which she was completely paralyzed. By that time, Vlad's father already died in a fire, and that's how the 8-year-old boy was left alone to deal with this unfortunate situation. The only option for the boy was a childhood at an orphanage. But Vlad was too strong and too stubborn to succumb to fate and to abandon his mother. Like a real man, he took on all the responsibilities around the house and did everything he could to get his mother back on her feet. It is worth mentioning that the family neighbor played a big part in this matter. The woman didn't become Vlad's legal guardian, but also dealt with all the issues regarding the social services. However, the rest of the responsibilities the boy had to take on his own. Can you even imagine? Being only 8 years old, Vlad already had to deal with all the adult realities of this unfair world. Vlad's story only got covered by the media when he was already 16 years old, and literally in a matter of days, not a single person was left indifferent over the story of a very strong young man. Just think about it, for all those years, Vlad single-handedly cooked, cleaned the house, chopped wood, and kept the house warm. He also had to find time to study, but most importantly, he fed, bathed, and changed his sick mother. Even when Tatiana got very, very sick and couldn't even talk, the boy still didn't give up on her. Every night, after a hard day's work, he armed himself with books, sat down next to his mother, and taught her how to pronounce basic sounds as well as to read. Unfortunately, getting appropriate treatment was out of the question for the family because it costs crazy money, which they simply didn't have. However, Vlad did everything in his power to make his mother get better. And jumping ahead, I'd like to say that his efforts were not in vain. A year later, his mother began to speak again. She spoke worse than before, but still. But you know what? That's not even the most interesting part. What's even more impressive is that given everything Vlad had to take care of, he still didn't give up on himself. The boy was making serious progress in kettlebell lifting, and the coach was very generous with approving remarks. According to the man, Vlad was one of the best students he's ever had. Vlad's personal life was also going well. The boy met Natsya at school. The poor student and the beautiful straight-A student fell in love at first sight, and soon they became a couple. Thus, Vlad wasn't dealing alone with his misfortune anymore, because soon his girlfriend, as well as her mother, started helping Vlad take care of his sick mother. Now the young man is already 24 years old. He learned to be a welder in order to find work in his hometown, so he wouldn't have to part with his mother. The family moved from the old house into an apartment donated by the officials. There are many kind people who continue to provide both financial and emotional support for the family. Vlad is rather successful at his job, and he even managed to buy a car. Natsya became a makeup artist, and they have maintained a warm relationship for many years. Natsya and her mother Alina are still helping take care of Tatiana, and she even began to move around on her own. She can help around the house a little bit. Of course, this story could have had a completely different ending, but the love and care of the only son, who never gave up on his mother, worked wonders. Nowadays, families where parents are taking care of their adult children are much more common. They buy them apartments and cars and otherwise provide for them. However, the boy named Vlad found himself in a situation where, being still a child, he had to take on the responsibility over the livelihood of his family. He did great to say the least. He never even asked for help. He just did what he had to do. This is what real men do, and we can all learn a thing or two from him. And Tatiana is very proud of her son and grateful to him for everything he's done.